Östersjön är ju ett ganska trångt hav och det är fyllt av öar och landmassa. Det gör ju att vi ofta får en knivig situation när det gäller tid. Vi kommer i tidsnöd. Och alla våra system måste därför vara mycket snabbare än vad man kan förvänta sig. Och sen behöver vi verkan för att kunna ta hand om hotet.
In the heightened state of airspace affairs, the outcome is decided by how well we manage what little time we have, as well as the ability to make split-second decisions in situations where the wrong choice can have potentially devastating consequences. This makes technology that helps us accurately assess and respond to potential threats an invaluable asset. And the extra seconds they provide make the difference between life and death. This is Shielding the Baltic Sea in the Air, Part 2.
The geography of the Baltic Sea is very particular. It's a confined and shallow space, lots of islands, an interesting landmass. And when you want to cross the Baltic Sea airspace, whether it's a drone, an aircraft, or some other missile, for instance, there is not a lot of reaction time. And planners have to account for that, as well as for the geography in terms of landmass, the maritime domain, the air domain, even cyber and space. So it's a very demanding environment to be planning your defenses.
A nation's airspace is continuously monitored using a variety of radar systems and sensors on surface vessels, aircraft, and ground installations. These integrated systems then compare and exchange data, leading to improved assessments and situational awareness for better decision-making.
The conflicts of our time happen in various domains at the same time. They are no longer limited to a single domain like the air, the maritime or the space domain. So we have to think about conflicts in a 360-degree environment, various domains interacting with one another, and we have to make sure that we have a full operational capabilities as well as full operational pictures to deter and to defend in these multiple domains, cross domains, inter domains, and that is a conceptual, technological and intellectual challenge.
Enemy aircrafts and missiles emit radio waves that echo throughout the domain as they bounce off surrounding objects. These echoes are then picked up by our systems, revealing potential threats within the airspace to our operators well before human sensors ever could.
Och vi behöver ju ett system nu som både kan upptäcka dem, och sen behöver vi förstå vad det är för hot och hur vi ska hantera det, och sen behöver vi verkan för att kunna ta hand om hotet. Och alla våra system måste därför vara mycket snabbare än vad man kan förvänta sig. Det kräver alltså en snabb beslutsprocess och en snabb verkanscykel.
Upon identifying a potential threat, an advanced command and control management system, CMS, immediately springs into action. This sophisticated system possesses the capability to track the trajectory and speed of the detected signal, allowing the CMS to predict future positions of the target with remarkable accuracy. Through the integration of artificial intelligence and machine learning, the data can then be analyzed to identify the nature and aim of the target.
Det är det som gör att automation kommer in istället för att snarare köra det manuellt.
Should the CMS's evaluation indicate that the incoming object poses a potential threat, it will then take action, involving further systems that are able to provide operators with real-time intelligence, aiding them in making the both critical and time-sensitive decision of whether to treat the object as a friend or foe.
Vi har både aktiva sensorer, radar och andra, och passiva sensorer som kan upptäcka sådana här hot. Vi samlar det i ett ledningssystem som kan reda ut vad det är för ett hot. Och sen har vi ett antal olika verkansdelar med som vi kan välja och använda. Det blir en hel funktionskedja. Det är ju sensorerna i det automatiska luftförsvaret som upptäcker det som vi vill ta hand om. Och vi vill ju se saker och ting så långt ut som möjligt, både tidsmässigt och avståndsmässigt, så att vi skapar oss time to act.
By tracking and identifying potential threats, we allow for a more comprehensive assessment of the situation. But that's not all. Through the use of active radars, passive sensors, and the combat system, enough information is gathered to also predict future scenarios, allowing us to devise appropriate countermeasures ahead of time. Finally, should it become necessary, a violation of airspace by a foreign aircraft is met by dispatching a fleet of fighter jets, sending a deterrent message to the intruding aircraft. Oftentimes, that is enough. However, if the intruder refuses to fall back, other countermeasures may include surface-to-air missiles, anti-aircraft guns, or electronic warfare systems.
I think there are a number of key challenges in the Baltic Sea region. The first one is we have to understand the Baltic Sea is back as an operating theater and as an area where conflict happens. It's also an area where cooperation happens. We need to understand, secondly, that the Baltic Sea can only be understood in the wider geographic sense of the northern flank of and the defense of Europe.
Creating time to act equals maximizing the use of the time available to us. Optimization of procedures, seamless connectivity and communications, together with harmonized doctrines across the entire defense apparatus, creates time to act swiftly. Advanced sensors and radars, complete with machine learning algorithms, enables more accurate decision making. When a potential threat becomes hostile, the defense or our society relies on advanced weapon systems that have the capability of eliminating and outsmarting our adversary. When facing a swarm of drones, multiple jets or missiles, we need to be prepared to act. Making the entire Baltic Sea and its airspace a safer place and maximizing the chances of countering potential threats in an appropriate way. As our journey comes to an end, we reflect upon the remarkable progress made within the field of defensive technology. As we've seen, each element, from the depths of the Baltic Sea to the skies above it, poses its own set of challenges and threats. And yet, thanks to the unwavering determination and ingenuity of the men and women protecting the Baltic Sea, we as a society are better equipped than ever against both conventional and hybrid attacks. As technology inevitably progresses, new challenges are sure to follow in its wake, demanding increasingly advanced technologies in order to keep us safe. It is therefore of the utmost importance to remain vigilant, continue to adapt, and continue our efforts to stay ahead of the curve. As a society, we must confront these challenges collectively with contributions from the military, industry, government, and civil society. As we close this chapter, let us carry with us the lessons learned, the significance of cooperation beyond national borders, the power of technological advancement and communication between domains closely interlinked, and the need for perpetual vigilance in the face of whatever comes next. By embracing these principles, we pave the way for a future where the defense of the Baltic Sea remains steadfast and secure, keeping people and society safe for years and generations to come.